Hello everybody, welcome back to the Metal Scrapper channel. Today, as the title says, I will talk about fluxes. So, what the flux? As you already know, some of you, I will cast some aluminium stuff, like Ducati logo soon. And I want to do that the correct way. I want to do it right now. So I was thinking about fluxing aluminium. You got several fluxes, and I did some research on the internet. Also did some research on YouTube, but on YouTube I couldn't find that much. There's some channels talking about fluxes, and the most you will hear and see is about borax. Borax is easy to get on the internet, but I hear positive stories about borax and some more negative. So I want to make my own flux, and I went searching on the internet and I came to this website. It's called substack.com, and you see some topics on metal casting. If you look for metal casting, I just searched on Google for aluminium or aluminum fluxing, and one of the sites popped up was Substack. So I went to that site and got some information. There are different kind of fluxes for aluminum or aluminium. And I want to start out with a two or three fluxes I want to use. Maybe want to use. And I want to open up a conversation on this topic. So I hope you all will reply on this if you have any knowledge or any experience with fluxes so far. Because I'm still not sure what to do exactly. So if you see at this site, we have fluxes for melting aluminium, and there's some standard definitions for it. Those are a solid substance used in aluminum foundries in order to reduce the melt oxidation, minimize penetration of the atmospheric hydrogen, absorb non-metallic inclusions suspended in the melt, and keep the furnace level wall clean from the built-up oxides, decrease the content of aluminium entrapped in the dross, and remove hydrogen dissolved in the melt. Now, then you have got some other uses, so like provide aluminium grain refining during solidification. That means it will give a smoother finish, but I'm not sure if I want to use that kind of flux. And you have modify silicon inclusions in silicon containing alloys. So aluminium dust has silicons, so you can also make a flux for that. And you have one flux for oxidized excessive magnesium. Well, for the last three, so the grain refining, modify silicon inclusions and oxidize excessive magnesium, I don't think I'm going to use that one. But I want to do is the next fluxes. As a basic, I want to use the cover flux, as you can see here in this, this site. And it says melting point over a cover flux is lower than that of aluminium. Cover flux is applied on the surface of molten aluminium, where it melts, forming a continuous layer protecting the liquid metal from oxidation and absorption of atmospheric hydrogen. So what it does, what it says it does is makes a when it melts, it forms a layer on top of the molten aluminium, so there will it won't get any oxidation in it. And cover fluxes are composed of a mixture of natrium chloride and kalium chloride. So natrium chloride sounds it sounds like a lot of chemistry, but it's just a regular table salt or kitchen salt, so it's not difficult to get on that kind of salt. And you have kalium chloride, and it's also quite easy to get that on the internet. And it may also contain some additions of calcium chloride and calcium fluoride, or even kalium fluorides. Now, the fluorides are also quite easy to get on the internet. What I'm asking myself now is if I want to make a cover flux. I have natrium chloride or salt, and I add kalium chloride and kalium correction, calcium chloride or calcium fluoride or kalium fluoride. My question now is, how much of each do I have to put in to get a good copper flux? So if anyone knows that answer, please comment down and I will try it out. Otherwise, I will just start out mixing. And if I look up on the internet, some of the materials are quite expensive. Like you have some of the materials is 100 grams and it costs almost 50 euros. So I think there won't be needed too much inside the flux. But that's just a good guess. Yeah, there's also another flux. And the basics is all the same. It all starts with natrium chloride, so salt and kalium chloride. And then you have to add another chemical component for the drossing fluxes, as the drossing fluxes already says. It will separate the promoted separation of molten aluminium and trapped in the dross. And sometimes that will be up to 80%. It will also get the wettability or the fluidity of the metal at a higher level. So if I'm going to pour my aluminium for the Ducato logo, I think I will have it more fluid if I can do that. So I will also make a drossing flux. And it, like it's already said, sometimes it will get out more metal out of the dross, up to 80%. So that's also a good one. So you have less dross, more molten aluminium, and it will be more fluid. So yeah, I also want to make that. And the basic ingredients are also natrium chloride and kalium chloride. those are a lot of chemistry words. Yeah, it has as ingredients the prenamed chlorides and fluorides, but it also contains an oxidizing component, and that is called KNO3. We'll look that up. KNO3, the chemical component, is called kalium nitrate, and so I have to buy that. So I will add that too. If someone knows in which mixture I have to do that, how much percentage of each chemical component to mix it, please let me know down in the comments, and I will start to make that. You have another kind of flux, the cleaning fluxes. Maybe I will do that if there's a lot of impurities in my metal, because as the name already said, it will clean the metal. And if I read it here, it's a cleaning flux which removes oxides suspended in the melt. And it's similar to the drossing fluxes. And the cleaning flux is composed of a mixture of the chlorides, the fluorides, and an oxidizing agent. So I think if I make the drossing flux, it will almost be the same as the cleaning flux. So I will use a copper flux, a drossing flux, and there's one more which I might be using if my cast comes out with a lot of bubbles and air pockets. I want to make a degaussing flux. And it says here, flux is composed of chlorine, again the chlorine, and fluorine containing salts are used for degassing molten aluminium alloys. Degassing fluxes are commonly shaped in form of tablets. Well, I will, if I make my own degassing flux, I will mix it and put it in a aluminium foil and then drop it in the melt and try to bring it to the bottom with my steering rod. And let's see what's also inside. Yeah, the flux components react with aluminium forming gaseous compounds. That's the aluminium chloride, aluminium fluoride. Yeah, so it will form some bubbles, and those will extract the gases out of the aluminium. I don't see any other chemical components it needs to be made of. So maybe it's, if I have correct, I have the standard ingredients like natrium chloride and kalium chloride, and I can add some calcium chloride, calcium fluoride, or kalium fluoride. And I think it depends on the how much I will put it in, if it will be a cover flux or a degassing flux. And if I want to make a drossing flux, I only need to add the kalium nitride. So this is what I want to use. So the cover fluxes, drossing fluxes, and a degassing flux. All the other fluxes I I'll skip that for now, maybe on a later stage. So please let me know in the comments down below if you have any experience with fluxes, and maybe you have a tip for me with other ingredients. So just let me know, and what works and what will not work, because I have never ever fluxed a metal. Yeah, this is it, the fluxes. So what the flux? Yeah, I'm looking forward for any input on that, and I hope to cast the logo real soon, within 2 weeks, and maybe have a flux in that to make it more fluid and remove impurities and maybe some gases. So yeah, I hope you all guys you like this video. If so, leave a comment, especially for this video. Give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.